So basically, when you put it into wherever you're gonna sit it, like get to the bottom, and there's. I'm using a little different crawl. We're gonna see what they like. And this is another trick, by the way. Like if your line ever gets used up and it's like whiter colored because you've used it so much, you can. That's the best right there. You can get a Sharpie, preferably one with a big tip, works better. Black one, and then you can color your line, and it makes it blend in and water a jillion times better. And you can either tie it before you tie the knot, but sometimes it'll get a little black on your leader if you tie a leader. Yeah, do you see all that cover? The bass sitting it. It's all the way down the shoreline like that. So, yeah, but this might be good because it's shade. Yep, there's one right there. Look, two. Alright. So you can just come down the shoreline. And flip here, or off that point, or whatever. I got one. Yep, they wanted the shade. I was wondering why that side was so empty. Number one. They're not very big, but something to get. Yeah, it was right in that hole. Well, when I said hole, I just mean it's a spot that he was sitting in. It was just, basically, for him, it was a separation and like a piece of sticks that he was chilling. It wasn't much special. I threw it in there and I was kind of all tangled up, so I didn't think I had a fish, and I could feel the tick, tick, tick. And he was holding on to it, so I did the honors and put a hook in his face. We're switching to a really small Senko too. This is like a 3-inch or 4-inch Senko or something. That should do good if I can get it. Oh yeah. Oh my gosh. I can't even believe he got that in his mouth. But, yeah, that's why I like this corner, because they push the minnows up here. That's how they do it in just about every corner. Oh, here we go! I didn't even know how big it was, but I saw my line start moving, and I didn't like it. So, yeah, just let it sit down, and then pop it. Rip the gills out of this thing. Okay. Sorry, buddy. I'm really sorry. I think I just killed you, but I guess you're gonna be on YouTube. That was interesting. Yeah, I flipped it in there and I was watching my line just slowly go, and then it just went 0 to 100 real quick. When you put it in there, and you give it like two subtle twips, you see how it like curves and then it goes backwards and like stops? So it almost feels like it's going back. You want it to do that in the water. So just two, three, four, five, whatever. Just as long as you get a stop in there. Usually you want to move it about 3 or 4 feet. Yeah. Not much, maybe just a foot or so under the water. So 3 or 4 seconds. And then while that's happening, you're going to want to watch your line, and then you can pick it up and start working it. Swimming at me, eh? Yeah, but we can get past him. I put two on the cast here. Not really any size to him. And, I think nine. I caught about 9 bass at another pond, and he caught two or three or something. Oh, that's a nice one. That's a nice one. I just got like a 2. Hey. Hey, damn, Daniel. Try to tell you to come down here. Mason! Double up, Mason! Look at my baby! What? Is my red light going? There's a fat. Look at how fat that mass is. I was gonna leave, but then I was like, hey, I gotta go. I think I'm gonna really leave now. That stick's got me, like, convinced that I should stay. It's like, Ben, stay. Oh my gosh. You are a legend, dude. That's a nicer one. Ow. I lost my Senko. He's not too bad.